Hey there, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the HTTP2 protocol error. Using the HTTP2 network protocol, you can reach websites faster than ever before. However, you may stumble across an error, HTTP2 protocol error. This can prevent you from accessing certain web pages. With the help of this video, you can easily remove this troublesome message and continue with your normal online browsing. But before we get started, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's fix this protocol error in a browser. Once you receive this error, you can start troubleshooting to find the source of the issue. Although we'll fully discuss some methods you can use, there are some simple fixes that you can start with. First, try refreshing the web page. Hitting F5 on your keyboard will send a request with an if modified since header. If the site was temporarily down, this may solve the problem. Alternatively, you can visit the site using a different browser. You may also want to close some tabs if there are too many open. If the error persists, continue with the following methods. If you're making searches with an outdated browser, this can easily lead to an HTTP2 protocol error. This is because your browser's data packets are incompatible with the site you're trying to load. To fix this problem, you can update your browser. Using Google Chrome, you can simply click on the three-dot icon in the upper right-hand corner and select Update Google Chrome. If you don't see this button, your browser is likely already up to date. To check if this is the case, go to Help, then About Google Chrome. This will prompt Google Chrome to check for a new update. If there is one, it will automatically install it. To finish updating, you need to relaunch the browser. If you're using the Google Chrome mobile app, you can simply open the App Store or Play Store, depending on your device type. Then check for any app updates and install them. Whenever you experience issues during the rendering process, it's a good idea to clear your browser data. By clearing your cache, cookies, and history, you can enable visited websites to authenticate your device and fulfill the request. Depending on your browser, there are a few different ways to clear the cache. For Google Chrome, you can select More Tools, then Clear Browsing Data. Using the pop-up window, you can specify the information you want to clear. You'll want to be sure to select Cached Images and Files, but you can also get rid of your browsing history, cookies, and other data. If you're using Safari, it will be a similar process. To do this, go to Safari and then Clear History. Then you can choose to clear your cache, cookies, and site data from a specific time range. When you're done, click on Clear History. To clear your browser data on Mozilla Firefox, you need to find the hamburger icon in the upper right-hand corner. Next, select History. In the new tab, click on Clear Recent History. Like other browsers, you can choose only to clear certain data. However, it's important to remember to select the cache option. Now that you've cleared your browser cache, try to visit the website where the error occurred. If you still see the error message, you'll need to try some alternative solutions. Whenever you visit a new website, your browser will save information about that site in a cache. Once you visit the page again, your browser will pull that cache data rather than requesting the server all over again. Often, this can make the site load faster on repeat visits. For this reason, you may want to avoid clearing your browser cache when trying to bypass the HTTP2 protocol error. In this case, you can launch the browser in private or incognito mode. This can be an effective one-time solution to avoid permanently deleting the cache or disabling third-party extensions. To do this in Google Chrome, extend the menu and click on New Incognito Window. This will open a private browser. Using the incognito mode, try to visit the website again. It may enable you to do this without having to use more complicated solutions. However, keep in mind, this is primarily a short-term fix. As we mentioned earlier, third-party extensions could potentially interfere with how your browser and web page interact. After you see the error message, you can consider disabling these extensions to see if the error disappears. To do this in Google Chrome, visit More Tools and then Extensions. This will take you to a web page that lists your Google Chrome extensions. First, use the switches on the bottom right corner to turn off each extension. Now that your extensions are disabled, try to go to the webpage that caused the error. If the webpage loads, you know that one of your extensions caused the problem. Now you can go back to the extension page and enable them one by one. After you turn on an extension, see if the error returns. When you find the problematic extension, consider removing it entirely. QUIC UDP Internet Connections is an encrypted transport network protocol that was developed by Google. Essentially, its goal was to increase the speed, security, and efficiency of HTTP traffic. Currently, only 8% of websites use QUIC. Therefore, when sites aren't configured to process this kind of traffic, it can cause incompatibility between the client and the server. As a result, this can display an HTTP2 protocol error. To solve this problem, you can turn off the QUIC protocol in your browser. Within Chrome, you'll simply need to enter the following URL into your search bar. Now you'll see a highlighted result labeled Experimental QUIC Protocol. For this setting, change it to Disabled. Once you make this change, you'll need to relaunch your browser. This will disable QUIC, allowing you to view the incompatible website. As you use Google Chrome, you may not notice small glitches that can change its default settings. Over time, this can lead to more errors like the HTTP2 protocol error. Fortunately, you can get your browser back to normal by reverting its settings to the default options. To get started, open the Google Chrome settings page. On the left, find the Reset Settings tab. Then, select the Restore settings to their original default options. Finally, you'll just need to confirm that you want to erase your current Chrome settings. If you do, click on Reset Settings. It's important to keep in mind that this will erase your current search engine history, startup page, pin tabs, extensions, bookmarks, and more. It will essentially revert your browser to a clean slate. However, it can remove any conflicting software or settings that are causing the HTTP2 protocol error. You can also consider resetting the experimental settings in your browser. These are not fully tested functional features, so they could prevent your browser from communicating properly with a website. To find your advanced experimental settings, search for the following address. In the upper right-hand corner, select the Reset All option. If certain features were accidentally enabled, this will revert them to the default settings. Then, these changes will be applied whenever you relaunch Chrome. After executing all these methods, you may still see the troublesome HTTP2 protocol error. If so, there could be an error within the Google Chrome app. Even if you restored the default settings, you may want to consider reinstalling the entire browser. First, you'll need to delete the browser from your device. To do this with a Mac OS operating system, open the Applications folder and move the Google Chrome app to the trash. You'll also want to delete any Chrome software updates. To find them, search for your library folder and then the Google folder on your device. In your results, delete the Google Software Update folder. If you're a Windows user, you'll use different steps to delete Chrome. To start, click on the Windows Start button and search for the Control Panel. Open it, then find the Programs option. Click on Uninstall a program under Programs. Now you'll need to find Google Chrome and right-click on it. Lastly, hit Uninstall. For both Mac and Windows users, you can reinstall Chrome in the same way. You'll simply need to download the file included on the Google Chrome website. Although this method could potentially solve the HTTP2 protocol error, it's best only to use it as a last resort. Deleting Chrome will also remove any of its data, so be sure to try a few simpler solutions beforehand. Now, let's discuss how to make your device compatible with the HTTP2 protocol. Although it may not seem like a big deal, it's important to have the correct date and time displayed on your device. If this information isn't accurate, the incorrectly timestamped data packets could be refused. This can lead to an error HTTP2 protocol error. With a Windows operating system, you can right-click on the clock in the bottom right-hand corner of your desktop. Then select Adjust Date and Time. If your computer isn't automatically displaying the right time, you'll need to disable the Set Time Automatically setting. Beneath this, be sure to set the correct time zone. Next, select the Change button to set the date and time manually. In the pop-up window, enter the correct date and time. For Mac users, click on the Apple menu, then select System Preferences. Here, find the Date and Time option. In the bottom left corner, click on the lock to make changes. Now you can deselect the Set Date and Time Automatically option and choose the correct values. After you make these changes, try relaunching the web page. If you haven't updated your device in a while, this can cause a multitude of performance issues. To ensure you can avoid any conflicts between your operating system and visited websites, you'll need to check for recent upgrades. Using a Mac OS device, you can start by performing a backup. Then go to System Preferences, then to Software Update. In this window, you'll see any newly available updates. If you're ready to install them, click on Update Now. With a Windows computer, you can navigate to Start, then to Settings, and then Windows Update. If you haven't already, install the latest update. Once your device is up to date, it should be compatible with most websites that you want to visit. To see if this is the case, check whether the protocol error is fixed. If not, continue with the following methods. On the internet, the DNS functions as an index for all available websites and their unique IP addresses. When you visit a website, your operating system or browser will save this information in a database. This can lead to faster loading times on revisited websites. If you're seeing the HTTP2 protocol error, you can try flushing your DNS cache. Put simply, this will erase the IP addresses and other DNS data from your computer. To flush a Mac DNS cache, open the command line interface called Terminal. In this window, enter the following command. This should successfully clear the DNS, removing the HTTP2 protocol error. However, keep in mind that you'll need to use slightly different processes for older versions of macOS. If you have Windows 10, 8, 7, or XP, you can start by opening Command Prompt. In the command line, put this command. You should see a confirmation message once the DNS has been flushed. To keep your computer safe while you're browsing, you likely have an antivirus program installed. Although this software offers many security benefits, it can occasionally flag certain applications as malicious. When this happens, it may unnecessarily limit your access to a website. If none of the previous methods worked, you can check your antivirus software to see if it's functioning properly. First, open your notifications, which can display new security issues. Most antivirus software will also have a quarantine list. This will contain all of the detected security threats on your computer. In either of these areas, evaluate whether any unwanted applications are being flagged. If so, you may need to temporarily disable your antivirus software. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.